So what we have here is a birch polypore, also known as razor strop. It's a bract fungus, attaches itself to the tree or grows from the tree from this point here. As you can see in the video, it wasn't too hard to remove from the tree. The thing about this is it can actually be used for sharpening knives, hence the name razor strop. It can be used as a tea, and when it's processed for tea, it can actually boost your immune system. The skin that you see here, it's kind of like wet crushed velvet, maybe. You can take slices off this and it can be used as an antiseptic plaster. I'm sure there's a couple of other uses for it, but I've been looking for this for about 2 years here now, and it just so happened I was down at the river yesterday and I spotted it. So yeah, let's see how this goes, right? And try to remove the section of it for a plaster. Look at the thickness of this. It's actually thicker than the spine. You wrap it around your cuts like so, and it'll stop infection getting into it. As you can see, you know, you get quite a few plasters. This is a considerable sized one. Most of the ones on that tree are roughly the same size. When you remove the skin, I'll give you a proper look there, it almost looks kind of rubbery. When you remove the skin, as you can see, it's starting to rip here. It does rip quite easily. as with all mushrooms, you'd want to get at least 3 positive identifications on it. For whatever it is you're using it. All mushrooms are edible, some only once. This is actually proving a bit tricky. Okay, let's just pull it off. You get the idea of it now. It's cleaned up. And in order to use this for a strop, you would level it off so you have a completely flat surface. And you just rub your knife like so across the fungus. Now, this knife is really sharp, and I probably should have used my other one just to show you how good it actually is. I mean, even getting this piece for a strop, you're still left with these little pieces that can be used for your dig, your tincture, whichever it is you're looking for, plasters. You want to get this as flat as possible. Yeah, should have used my other knife, but it is what it is for demonstration purposes. But like I was saying, you just rub your knife across it, like so. Yeah, a few little hairs, but not much. Oh yeah, that's it. For this one, birch polypore. Smells kind of nice. Will I use it for a tea? Probably not. I'm gonna chill out with the river, dunk my head, take in the sunshine across the rocks, and keep an eye out for other fungus growing along. So, bob outdoors. Birch polypore.